Rajiv Pradhan, I am a robot dog. Rajiv, what on earth are you on about? Hey guys, you're probably here because you want to know all about excessive sweating and what you can do to reduce it. Well, I'm going to answer that question along with many other questions in this week's Responding to Your Comments, where we look at fun questions, we look at science-based questions, but most importantly, we look at the evidence. Andy JR, dear Abraham, can you please do a video to help with excessive sweating? Andy JR, thank you for your comment. This is from the How to Lose Weight video, and of course I can. So excessive sweating is otherwise known as hyperhidrosis. That's what we call it in the medical world. It can be localized to one area, or it can affect the entire face or the entire body. It can be quite embarrassing to deal with, especially when it starts to interfere with people's lives, I guess. So once again, Andy, thank you for your comment. Now, the good news is that sometimes it does get better with age, but there's also many things that you can do to help with it. But before we learn about that, let's first learn about the condition itself. So sweating is controlled by the brain. It sends signals via the sympathetic nerves to small sweat glands in the skin. These nerves are part of the autonomic nerves, so it's responsible for all the unconscious functions that we don't actually realize. So for example, when our body temperature increases, when we're feeling anxious, we tend to sweat more. But please remember that hyperhidrosis affects the water producing eccrine sweat glands and not the apocrine sweat glands that produce a more oily sweat that generally have an odor and are found under the armpits, for example. So what this means is that hyperhidrosis isn't a direct result of bad odor, unless you have hyperhidrosis of the feet, which there are some harmless bacteria there that can cause an unpleasant odor. Now, there are different types of hyperhidrosis, and the most common is localized symmetrical hyperhidrosis that affects both sides equally. So for example, on the palms, under the armpits, on the soles, on the face, both sides are affected equally. It usually starts during childhood or adolescence, and it usually improves with age as well. We also have generalized hyperhidrosis, where the entire body is affected, and this can be caused by many things, such as infections, going through the menopause, diabetes, thyroid problems, and even medication. I will leave more information about all of these in the description below for you as well. Anxiety can also worsen hyperhidrosis, but this doesn't mean that the person is unusually anxious or stressed out. Another thing that can make hyperhidrosis worse is the worrying of sweating. This can cause quite a vicious cycle that actually makes it worse. And lastly, we have disease or irritation of the sympathetic nerve, which is quite rare, but it causes sweating across the whole body or localized on one area. So localized on one side of the face or one side of the body. So as you can see, there are quite a few reasons for hyperhidrosis. So the first advice I would give everyone is speak to your healthcare professional so they can check you out, so they can ask all the relevant questions, and also do all the examinations and test to make sure and rule out anything that might be causing the hyperhidrosis. This is the most important thing that everyone should do to begin with. And when there is an underlying condition causing the hyperhidrosis, by treating that underlying condition, it will most likely stop the hyperhidrosis. But let's say everything is fine, then there are many things that we can do to help control the symptoms, and that's what we're going to discuss now. So first off, there are a few simple changes that you can make, and if you haven't tried any of them, well, please do, because they can have quite a significant impact on reducing your hyperhidrosis. So for example, wearing looser fitting clothes, not wearing tight clothes that are made of man-made fabrics like nylon, for example. This is really bad and it causes a lot more sweating. Also, wearing a cotton t-shirt underlayer, this can also really help with hyperhidrosis of the entire body. And wear cotton socks that absorb the moisture and try to change them twice a day. Also, change your shoes daily and try not to wear tight shoes or tight trainers. All of these can make things a lot worse. It's also best to avoid soap containing products, so instead use an emollient as a soap replacement. This can have a very big impact. Also, if you drink alcohol or if you eat a lot of spicy foods, try and avoid these, as these are being shown to worsen hyperhidrosis. So these are a few simple changes that you can make that can have quite a big difference. But what about treatments? Let's talk about them now. So let's start with aluminium chloride. It's found in many commercially available antiperspirants, but there are much stronger ones available that you can purchase from your pharmacy. You can use them under your armpits, on your hands, well, the palms of your hands, on the soles of your feet. It can be very effective, but it can make your skin very sore to begin with. So the best thing that you can do is speak to your pharmacist first, one, to make sure that you're safe and suitable to use it, and two, so they can advise you how to use it properly to reduce the soreness of the skin. Also, please always read the information leaflet that comes with it, because it has some really good advice on it, and you'll also be able to know if you're safe and suitable to use it. There are some newer products available in the market as well that contain aloe vera with the aluminium chloride, and this is said to help reduce the soreness, so that could be a potential option as well. All other treatments have to be prescribed, such as glycopyrronium, there's also Botox, but I will leave loads more information about all of these in the description below, so if you're interested, check them out. I really hope my tips help you in this video, and if anyone has any of their own suggestions, please leave a comment below too, because I'd love to read it, and I'm sure anyone else watching this video would love to read it too, but always remember, you're awesome. Zeppet Damien, oh my god, I'm 34, I was using mouthwash or water right after brushing all my life. Thank you for that video. Zeppet Damien, thank you for your comment. This is from the How to Brush Your Teeth Properly video, which featured Dr. Ehsan, my good dentist friend. And yes, you would be surprised that a lot of people do that, so I'm really glad that that video could help you, and thank you for your comment. Pure Math, did you Naruto run in 4:37? Like if you did, this is one of those types of comments. Pure Math, thank you for your comment. This is from the How to Sleep Faster video. But I literally have no idea what a Naruto run is. So maybe let's have a look at it. And if anyone knows what a Naruto run is, please leave a comment below because I'm really intrigued.
2, 1, boom.
So it looks like we've run out of time again in this week's responding to your comments. If I didn't answer your question, I'm really sorry, but the best advice I can give you is leave another comment. We are getting so many comments nowadays that it's quite easy to miss it. So the best advice I can give is keep on leaving comments and it will catch my eye, it will catch my attention, and I will include it in a future episode of responding to your comments. Always remember, you're awesome, and I will see you next week. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.